Alrighty then, it's time for a Jungle Jarvan game. Let's get this show on the road. First one, it's been a while, hasn't it? I've basically been out of commission, because if you haven't followed my Facebook, I had a work-related injury. Hooray! Long story short, I had sciatica, and we were trying to figure out what it was caused by. And, you know, work insurance tends to give you the runaround with these things. I went through a month and a half of therapy, actually waiting quite a while for that therapy, like about a month before I actually got one. And then after the therapy was done, it turns out it didn't really do very much. So they finally gave me an MRI, and it turns out I dislocated a disc. Wow, if they had figured that out earlier, I would have been fixed a lot sooner. Instead, I was in some ridiculously hard medication for a while, and it basically made me lethargic, and I just didn't want to do very much. I just kind of sat around and wrote stuff. Thankfully, D&D was something that was within my realm of possibility, so just kind of played Dungeons & Dragons for a while. Not much anything else that was too stressful or whatever. So that's why I did not have League of Legends videos, or was I streaming? But now, since they figured out, hey, we could just fix his back and put him off the heavy medication, yay, I'm back in action, mostly. So yeah, my leg still hurts, I can't feel my toes, and my back is like feeling like it's gonna break anytime soon. But at least I'm more or less in full conscious. So yeah, I decided to play, you know, some of my favorite champions to see if I still got it. And it turns out, hooray, I still kind of got it, especially on Jarvan. Right now, though, the early game is pretty lame. The only kill gone off to Kayn because the enemy, or my teammate Sona, got a little bit too cocky and died for it. And then Ekko right here will probably kill Vel'Koz, because the Vel'Koz, throughout the game, you'll see, is a little bit too adventurous, if you get my drift. In this game, though, I am going for Black Cleaver first, and then I'm going with Dead Man's Plate, seemingly because I gotta be the initiator who can knock out either the Jace or the Tristana. Although, right now you can see that my Malphite is quite behind, and he's been, if you can't see the chat, but he's been complaining, dank for me. But I can give him some, you know, leeway here, because he did get autofill top lane, so he's just kind of struggling, burning all his mana, just trying to clear all these minions and losing farm. But alas, it's solo queue, so you guys already know my views on autofill. I hate it, and it's one of the reasons why, you know, playing League of Legends has been kind of a bummer sometimes. Anyways, I got level 6 now, so I can at least do something. The enemy team does a really forced gank that ends up kind of getting him a kill, but resulting in two deaths immediately, and then we catch the Thresh and kill him off too. So it was, all in all, a catastrophe for the enemy team. And then Ekko decides to use his E and his Q on minions because, hooray, there's definitely no threat nearby that was totally killing my teammates. So flash EQ, he flashes ultimate, kill him. Hooray for me, that was pretty easy kill on the Ekko, who reacted very poorly and did something really stupid. So yeah, I love it when they do that. If you guys saw the stream when I was watching that, you would remember that I was like, oh my god, when I saw him use his E, because I knew if I ulted him, he'd be dead. In the meantime, though, Malphite is still getting upset because Jace is just kind of running circles on him. Malphite is burning most of his mana and obviously engaging in really weird fights, but thankfully I get there in time, and thankfully the Jace also misses his Q, and I managed to stab him in the butt and get the kill. So hooray, 2 kills, 0 and 1. Yeah, it's so far good for me. The enemy Jace is so far not much of an issue either. If he goes Rost, or if I'm during the game, if I figured, if he goes Rost, it'd be pretty damn good against my team. If we fail to defend the Misfortune, we should probably fall apart. Here, though, it was kind of funny. He went right where my flag was, so I got a free EQ on him without having to use my E, and it chunked him for a lot. And for whatever reason, he kept underestimating my ability to burst him down, so just got a little bit too close and died. So essentially, that was a pretty free kill. And then Neko comes in and gets a free kill of his own. Well, mostly free kill. He took a lot of damage, had to use his ultimate, and, you know, wasted a little bit of time, but still a kill. And he got himself a bounty kill too. So alas, but yeah, Jarvan. From what I know, apparently he's sort of like mid-tier jungler right now. Kind of sad. A lot of my favorite junglers have been getting nerfed. Trundle sort of got dumpstered, apparently. Or at least they made him a lot harder. And by the way, they're all super distracted. If I had paid attention, I would have been able to smite secure that blue buff. Like, oh, Jesus Christ. But yeah, if only I could show you team chat. And I know you could turn toggle all chat, but team chat still doesn't show up anymore. The amount of back and forth, like, hey, help us, we're getting camped, come top lane, I can't do this, is enormous. And I'm trying to ping for my teammates to do things too, and thankfully the Malphite listened.
Although our damage is extremely low, we only really kill Thresh. Thankfully, the Vel'Koz shows up a little bit late and gets to do some damage. Malphite gets killed, and then the Jace does some really odd thing where he uses all his abilities on the Skota, knowing that we're kind of nearby. So I just EQ back in and kill him off. Rost misses his W, so he just kind of has to scatter away. I EQ forward, a blue smite up to try to give him a chase, W to slow him a little bit further, and then I just tank the tower so my Sona and my Misfortune can try to kill him. If I had gone for it, he had a chance to knock me up and kill me under the tower, so I just, you know, took the tower shots. So hooray for participation. I kill them by proxy. So 4-1-3, that's pretty damn good, and my farm is pretty respectable, right? There's a reason I'm repeating this kind of often. You would think that this performance on my Jarvan is pretty stellar, right? Probably worth a name, and dare I say, maybe even an S. Yeah? All right, well, remember that by the end of this video, okay? What I just said there. Anyways, the Echo gets super greedy with that scuttering, gets chucked by the Misfortune, and just kind of ignores the fact that I can burst him down. So a pretty easy lemon speezy kind of kill on the Echo right there. We go for top tower, although leaving Jace to bottom lane when he has the Herald is kind of a bad idea, and the Malphite just ignores that. Go after the Tristana, although my EQ thing didn't work, even though it sometimes works when you get knocked back from something. We're going to be able to take this second tower, I believe, if my memory recalls. But unfortunately, the Jace is just kind of blasting through our tower, so... The Echo, once again, completely ignores that hard CC, destroys him if he can't use his ultimate. I get chunked down by the Tristana and the tower and get brought down. But then, as a result, we also kill the Thresh and the tower, so hooray for us. And, of course, again, we're trading towers with the Jace, who's got Herald on his side. We are more than two kills ahead of... Well, twice the kills against the enemy team. And then they pick up the Malphite here, just poor little Malphite who didn't run away as fast as he could. And my teammates are down, my Misfortune and my Sona are down bottom lane. They're going to have to defend mid lane while we're going to get sort of sandwiched at top lane. This little whole situation is a little odd. So I immediately EQ these two since I knew they were going to be here in ultimate, hopefully trying to get as many abilities out of them as possible. Because if I do that, then the next subsequent teamfight that we're likely going to have is going to be stronger for us. Thresh is pretty threatening for our team composition since we all kind of have to walk through that wall of death. EQ him, knock him out. My teammates are a little bit scattered. The enemy team is definitely having communication issues here because some of them want to go for something and the other ones are trying to escape, so it results in some easy pickings for us. Flash EQ, grab the Jace, and obviously he's just going to get killed too. So for the Vel'Koz kill, which is mostly because the rest of my team wasn't really there and the enemy team was all kind of super disorganized, we got 3 kills. Pretty good, if I do say so myself. So yeah, right now my main target is, oddly enough, the Thresh. Because like I said, Rost and Thresh are some of our bigger threats. Because if Rost is able to get somebody, some important from my team, you'll easily probably pick them off. Most importantly, like the Misfortune. Thresh is their only sort of initiation. So if I control him and keep him from using his wall on some, if Q, using his Q on something important or his wall on the enemy team or on my team, then we should easily destroy them. That's my goal right now. Plus, we gotta, if you can, I forgot to mention that you can rewind that, how I handled that. So the Malphite caught the Jace, right? But anyone who's paying attention knows the Thresh was going to bail him out regardless. So I just ignored it and kept walking forward so I would not lose the distance required to EQ both of them. That was me, you know, playing chess while they were all playing checkers. Or Mahjong, I don't know. Anyways, essentially put, I'm pretty dominant right now and has allowed the Misfortune to also snowball out of control. And the Sona is, you know, doing a Sona build. And you, early on, she kind of, you know, rushed a different item than the one you see right here. Anyways, I don't know why the Tristana thought she'd get a little cocky and shoot me from the shadows, because I just completely assassinated her and Misfortune picked up the kill with the E. It's kind of a bad idea all in general, Tristana. I'm basically an assassin right now. I'm really far ahead. Had Deadman's Plate and a Black Cleaver. My initial burst is pretty damn strong, and hopefully I'll kill somebody important or, you know, grind through the enemy team and do something. Here again, I get Thresh. I just take him out of bounds and try to put myself a little bit forward in front of him, so I would be the one who gets queued. And his wall only really affects me. Again, the rest of my team, with the Malphite, as long as the Malphite gets a good ultimate or the Thresh gets a good in E with his ultimate of following it up, should melt their front line. So by controlling the Thresh, I at least, hopefully in my mind at that moment, made it so the enemy team couldn't, you know, disrupt my my team couldn't get disrupted and get off their wombo combo off properly. So at least, again, at least that's my view of this, my reasoning for picking up on Thresh instead of the rest of the team. Sure, I could have bursted them down alongside my teammates, but I felt that might be a little overkill because right now we got the Misfortune, we got the Bellcows, we got the Malphite. That's going to grind their squishy front line. They got no actual tanks. So hooray for us. It's pretty damn good. But unfortunately there, we got a victory and I knew they were going for the Baron and nobody else really came for me. So I tried to smite it, but the K beat me to the punch and then unfortunately I died. Yay, sadness. Fortunately, as a silver lining, the Echo for some reason decides to get a little too greedy. Look at him. EQs in and then he E's in and I don't know, it just gets CC locked and again he keeps forgetting that you need to be out of stunned. You can't use your ultimate if you're stunned, so he just kind of dies for free. That's not good. No bueno there, Echo. You just play a little bit more carefully. Does that kind of render their whole Baron a little bit pointless because they lost one of their heavy hitters? And again, just not having a tank makes it kind of worthless because they can't really initiate. Catch the Ross from the sides, EQ him, try to ult him, but Thresh saves his life. I should have seen that coming, so that was my bad on wasting my ultimate there. My teammate, my Vel'Koz, as I said earlier, keeps trying to be a little bit, you know, greedy over there. He's going to keep doing that. We're trying to push mid despite the fact that there's no inhibitor. And I'm trying to guide my teammates to the bottom lane because that's where we should be. But instead, you know, Vel'Koz is doing whatever and he gets himself caught. And he does kill the Thresh and the Echo is forced to run away because I'm coming closer. But Ross goes in gung-ho and finishes off the Vel'Koz. And then it's kind of a really slow, kind of awkward kill here, just kind of smacking him. If I use my EQ, I feel he might dodge it or make it bad. So I was just kind of, you know, trying to force him somewhere. He queues over the wall for some reason, knowing that Misfortune was going to kill him anyways. And if he had known or he had realized that Malphite was coming, he might have been able to cheap a kill against the Malphite before he got dropped. So, yeah. So, yeah, this game is going greatly in our favor. And it's mostly because the enemy team composition is extremely bad. Or at least bad against mine, because our initiation and then follow-up wombo combo is deadly sexy. Anyways, they engage on me. They basically tickle me at this point. They're, you know, the Echo is not really that strong. And the Ross, I have the armor to deal with it. So, hooray. And once again, though, my ultimate is pretty wasted because I don't know what I was thinking there. But yeah, the Vel'Koz is pushing down mid, even though the inhibitor is down. It gets the Sona caught, and me and the Malphite sort of rejoin the fight because, I don't know, we try to salvage this, but we should have just kind of backed away. Thankfully, again, silver lining, my teammates do kill at least two people before they're completely decimated. So, or completely annihilated. Decimated means, you know, 10%. But yeah, so the enemy team can't really amount to much of a push here because the minions are in their base and they got two dead. So, hooray. And then the Jace sort of picks a fight with me and I think he should have just run really quickly instead of whatever he was trying to do because he saw me coming. So it's an easy kill against him. And we're going to get self a dragon, but dragons are not really worth it at this point. Well, they're not worth completely contesting your entire team for it, unless they're red, probably. So we just get an easy lemon, whatever. Easy, squeezy lemon, squeezy, peasy, peasy. So here is a funny little situation, because it is one of the worst team fights I have seen in quite a while. So look at my position of my items. Normally, I would have my items on the third slot so I can use it with my Q, but I was mashing my hourglass or my time watch or stopwatch, and it was on the wrong button, so I didn't use it early enough. Still, though, it makes a really awkward fight for both teams, and it results in some very odd kills. The only reason the Misfortune is able to get anybody is because the enemy team burned a lot of their stuff on me. And then on Malphite, so she just kind of picks off everyone who has a low health, who decided not to run away for some reason. We get three kills for two. It's not a very good one because I shouldn't have died the way I did, but at least, again, silver linings, right? Or bronze linings at this point. We get ourselves two inhibitors and a tower, so it's not the worst situation. So now we're at least teaming up for the Baron, you know, clearing out the top lane, going for the Baron. And this whole little fight is one that I want to point out because of how it works. And again, I'm aiming for the Thresh. Control the Thresh, and the enemy team should falter. I go EQ on him immediately, trying to burn his abilities, and there you go. I saw him. I kind of baited him out. And then I just sort of walked in front of him. Because if I push him away, then he'll just get killed for free. But if he leads him to the enemy team, then just EQ right through them and trap them. Just right here. Trap two of important characters, Misfortune, Wombo combo with the Malphite, and they're absolutely melted. They lost two characters and then the rest of them rather quickly. Because I'm probably one of the worst targets they could go for, and I was the only target showing my face. So it was either lose Thresh or lose the entire team, and they gambled the team and lost. So, I mean, the Echo is the only one who will survive, but, you know, that cost them their base, and so, therefore, they surrender. So, hooray for Jarvan, and hooray for making my comeback. Hopefully, my back comes back, too. Yay!